In this tutorial, we will be creating the following effect. We will go over some of the basic layout of the interface, root events, the multiplier node, and the particle layer properties. This is the node graph. All of the different components of the particle system are displayed here. These components are called nodes. When selected, each node will have different properties that can be edited within the properties panel. All of the nodes within the system will also appear in the layers panel for easier access. This is the timeline of our particle system. Here, we can start, stop, fast forward, and restart the effect. By default, when starting a new effect, a root event is automatically created and displayed within the node graph. It is the initialization of our particle system. We will set how many particles we want to create in our system and how often. This can be done by creating a multiplier node. This node can be created in two different ways. In the first method, you can click on one of the pins of the node, drag, then search for the multiplier node. In the second method, you can right-click within the node graph and search for the multiplier node that way. In order for the system to know to run through the multiplier, you must link the two nodes. Simply click the root event and drag and drop onto the multiplier node. With the multiplier node selected, in the properties panel, under the emission section, we will set the duration to infinity, the spawn count mode to particles per second, and the spawn count to 10. Because we set the duration to infinity, we can disable the loop button. Next, we will create a particle layer node and link it to the multiplier node. The particle layer node is what determines the behavior of each particle and how it is displayed. Double-click the node in order to expose the node graph that belongs to the particle layer node. We will first add a float that will represent the lifespan of each particle. Set the value to be 10 and link it to the life node. Next, we will create a billboard renderer. This is what renders the particles in our system. We need to change several properties in order for the particles to render correctly. The diffuse map we will be using is the default white texture. Leave the transparent type to additive. After the initial setup of the billboard, you can now see particles on your screen. As we make changes to our graph, the effect will update. Renderers will be covered in other videos. For now, you are welcome to change the diffuse texture within the billboard node. Moving on, there are several parameters that we must define for our particles to behave like the initial example. The size parameter can be set by selecting the billboard node and inputting a value in the properties panel. The position input represents the particle world position. In order to simulate the gravity that pulls down the particles, we will create a physics node, set the Y acceleration to -3 in the properties panel, and link it to the billboard. In order for the particles to be properly transformed, we will create two nodes, local position to world and local direction to world. Link local position to world to position, and local direction to world to velocity. Transforms nodes and why they are needed will be covered in another video. Next, we will move all the particles from this layer one unit in the up direction of the emitter. We do this by creating a scene axis up node and linking it to our local position to world node. In order to add some randomness to our particles, we will create a VRAN node that will randomize the rotation of the velocity of each particle that is spawned. The last parameter needed is the color parameter. We can set the color in two different ways. In the first one, we can add a color node and fill in the values as follows. In the second one, we can select the billboard renderer and select the color widget right below the diffuse map. Now, you should have a particle system that resembles this.